Vrata Vanik Rajan. After the consolidation of the three major aspects of the Gotra, Kshetra and Sabha, we are entering into a wider horizon of the geographical mobility, socio-economic solidarity and political amalgamation. Geographical mobility indicates the movement of the man over a wider topology. That means man has started not only covering the hilly areas but also the other areas extending up to the sea. As a result, all the plains, shadow zones and then eco zones, they are all totally brought under the direct observation and mobility of the mankind. It is indicative of the geographical mobility. And secondly, man has started growing in his social organization and also economic solidarity. This is another dimension which is seen as socio-economic solidarity. All these two have componently resulted in what is called as the political amalgamation. In this period of the geographical mobility, socio-economic solidarity and political amalgamation, we can see three important aspects. One is called as Vrata, another is called as Vanik, another is called as Rajan. Vrata, what does it mean? Where it is referred to? Vrata literally means a group or a community. It can be understood with what is called as a small prototype of the present day tribe. This Vrata is referred to in Yajurveda as Vratebhyo Vratapati Bhyascho Namo Namaha. There is a Vrata as well as Vratapati. This particular Vrata is very clearly indicative of the growth of the human economy and the growth of the human society. And in the Vrata, we can identify a composition concluding of cattle, men and land. So these three are having three important things. One is called as cattle speaks about the biomorphic entity, man speaks about the anthropomorphic entity, land speak about the geomorphic entity. When the biomorphic, anthropomorphic and geomorphic entities are clubbed together, it is called as Vrata. This Vrata is indicative of the important things of the growth of the man in his cattle power and manpower, and also he started exploring and utilizing new innovations, utilizing the new forces in the earth. He wanted to find out the resources in the earth. Besides the mud, he wants to find out the water, he wants to find out the metals, non-metallic ores, and all these things are a part of the exploration for the products from the land. In this particular process, we can identify one of the important phenomena, what is called as wheel. Wheel is considered to be one of the landmarks in the history of mankind. But wheel is not simply understood as a physical identity. Here, wheel can be taken as a totemic archetype next to the fire. So the fire is the first totemic archetype. The cattle is the second totemic archetype, cow. And then comes what is called as the wheel. So the fire, cow and wheel form the three primary totemic archetypes. Why the wheel is having that particular polarity? It requires a command into understanding the epistemology of the wheel. Here, naturally, a question comes into existence. Why wheel is round? Any invention or intervention of the man is based on some physical truth or some natural truth, what man is observing, experiencing and enjoying. From that only, every invention has taken place. Wheel is also one in that particular thing. So man is regularly finding out three varieties of cycles. One is called as mass cycle. Mass cycle is based on the life and death. So from the life, the mass is taking birth, and from the death, the mass is decaying. Meanwhile, it is growing. It is called as life and death is the mass cycle. And also, there is a time cycle. From the spring season to the autumn season, we can see a particular varieties of time cycle. Spring season, summer season, autumn season, and then winter season. In this way, different type of cycles is found. It is called a time cycle. And beyond that, they are all controlled by one more thing, what is called as energy cycle, which is found out in the name of the day and night. That is why he can see in his regular way of life a mass cycle in the body, a seasonal cycle in the environment and also a time cycle which is controlling the total energy. This cyclical identity has led for a particular concept, what is called as wheel. That is why subsequently in the development of the Puranic iconography, almost all the gods immediately, for example, Vishnu or Shiva or Shakti, they are all given this particular wheel as a part of their limbs. That means the composition or the amalgamation of the mass cycle, time cycle and energy cycle is the basic identity here. Now we can find out one more phenomena, what is called as Vanik. What do you mean by Vanik? Vanik means merchant. So what is the role of the Vanik? So Vanik is an organization which is speaking for the exchange groups. Here we can identify that the Vanik is a particular person who is related with the land, cattle and sabha, but at the same time who is also exploring the wider horizons of the nature. As a result, the role of the Vanik have come into existence for identifying a new things. That is, there has been a social stratification. That particular social stratification is identified that the producing groups, cowherd groups and also the exchange groups. So that means there are producing groups, servicing groups and exchange groups, three varieties of social stratification have set in. Thus, Vanik will be marking an important thing, and Vanik also makes this particular land as well as cattle as the non-tangible and tangible values. So that means cow and land have emerged as the property for the first time. It is the effort, it is the idea of the Vanik, and he is in charge of the exchange groups. And now, thirdly, when we go for the political amalgamation, here Rajan is coming into existence. What is the concept of Rajan? Rajan, Ranjayati iti Rajnyaha. One who makes the people enjoyed is called as Rajan. So Rajan is related with three important things. One is Gotra, another is Grama, and another is Janapada. These Gotra, Grama, and Janapada, they are all, rather to say, amalgamated in the power of the Rajan. He has to amalgamate and provide a political solidarity, economic security and social organization. That is why in the social stratification, the producing groups, the servicing groups and the exchange groups are also added by the protective groups. Rajan has emerged as the protective group. Rajan is the combination of Pratapati and Sabhapati. The same Namakajamaka of Shukla Yajurveda in the Chaturudriya, they mention Pratebhyo Pratapati Bhyaccha O Namo Namaha Sabhavai Sabhapati Bhyaccha O Namo Namaha. So that means the Vrata and Sabha are joined together in order to make the Rajan a physical entity, a political entity, in order to become a supervisory entity. Rajan is considered to be Adhyaksha, Vishnu. Vishnu means all pervading. That means he is pervading over the Gotra, Sabha and Kshetra and also the Vanik. That means he is having a geographical mobility, he is having an economic mobility, he is having a social mobility, and at the same time he is having a specific organization. Many of the Upanishads are giving the example that how the king appoints different officers and makes the things done, it is indicative of the supervisory authority. That supervisory authority is considered to be, in the case of Rajan, as Vishnu Tattva, and that is why it has been told Na Vishnu Prithivipatihi. This particular adag is clearly indicating the importance of the political organization. So thus now we are entering a particular phase wherein the geographical mobility, socio-economic solidarity and the political amalgamation are the three important dimensions, but yet we have to understand that we have not entered into the phase of history. And here the records are simply traditional records and somewhat artifactual evidences and some architectural evidences and some archaeological evidences, but not yet we are coming across any written evidences. But yet we can clearly understand a proper society has come into existence. A concept of the prototype of the village, prototype of the tribe, prototype of the community have come into existence. They are demarcating the geographical mobility, socio-economic solidarity and political amalgamation. Here these Vrata, Vanik, Sabha and Rajan, they are playing a vital role. Vrata, by virtue of its having the Kshetra, it is considered to be the territorial organization. Vanik is the productive organization. Sabha is the social organization. Rajan is the political organization. Thus, we can understand very clearly that we are entering a phase of geographical mobility, socio-economic solidarity, and political amalgamation, which is succeeded by a period of intellectual revolution.